is she afraid
of? He's loving it.
He is Britain's technology magician. Jamie Allan combines magic with cutting-edge high-tech to entertain his audience, and he's here to join us now with one of his tricks. Good to see you.
Hi.
I am so excited to do this. I love the magic.
I'm not a big fan of the magic. It's nothing personal, Jamie.
No,
but
you're delightful.
Do you know, I say this, Robin, I don't actually, it doesn't worry me, because I think magic is, I don't think about magic being about fooling you. In fact, I think fooling you is quite a nasty thing to do.
Yes.
I don't like that at all. And I always say to people, when they say, I want to know how that's done, I feel that most of the time you really don't, because that's just the puzzle. But I don't present anything as a one-upmanship game. It's just a little bit of fun. And I'm
it's for
share.
Fun. Yes. Yeah. Okay. All right, bring it on.
And in fact, you were just saying that my show is all about mixing magic with tech, and this is actually really old. It's like a museum piece, and this is the first time I'm doing it on television. In my show, I take old ideas and try and find a new way of presenting them.
Okay.
So we do it with Houdini's water torture cell, and we do it with video mapping,
okay.
And it's very immersive.
All right.
And in the days when Houdini was around, he used to present magic, and people would say he was a magician or an escapologist, but and you may well be aware of this, but a lot of people don't know that Houdini was obsessed with spiritualism or exposing fraudulent
All
mediums
right.
and psychics. And during his show, he would take time to demonstrate that he could achieve through natural means what the spiritualists claimed to achieve through supernatural means. And I was lucky enough to come across some of the original wood from Houdini's actual spirit cabinet.
Get out of here.
Yeah,
and I've had it reconstructed.
Oh,
some of these bits are new into a modern version of one of Houdini's classic tricks. And this is the spirit box. And I'll show both of you inside this closely in a moment, but first, just for the camera.
Yeah.
Robin, would you mind taking one of these ropes and just checking them out? These have a breaking strain of a little over a ton, but I want you just to really check them, make sure they don't come apart.
Yeah.
There's no
just regular
things.
Ropes. Uh-huh.
But let me show you in the camera, if we can come in close here. I want you to see, it's a little bit strange because it's got a curtain on one side, it's got a curtain on the other, and it's got this funny little trap door on the top with these little notches cut out. But do you want to take a look at that?
Yeah, I'd love
check
to.
The sides, make sure there's nothing concealed in the back.
Uh-huh.
Here's the lid, it's got these little catches. They're new.
Uh-huh.
One of the new additions that hold it on. So I just want you
good
to see.
Lumber.
It's a strange box, but it's built to do precisely what you're
Got
about
it.
To see.
All right, ropes
and
are good.
Puzzle. Great. Okay, I'm going to close the little door there, and we're going to put a little bit of darkness, they would say, inside the spirit cabinet. We're going to take out the ropes. Now, if I wanted to join these ropes together, if I wanted to join the middles together, the only way that I could do it would be to take one end and pass it through the other one. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave the ends outside of the cabinet at all times. And I'm going to take just the centers. Now, Houdini always said that the magic only happens when things pass through the cabinet, which is why we've got this funny little door on the top, because I'm going to grab hold of the centers and kind of lock them into place.
Okay.
Now, if you look at the middles, you see the ends stay outside, yeah?
Yeah.
But if you look at the middle, something kind of strange happens to them. Now, this is really more of a puzzle, though, isn't it, Robin?
Yeah.
Than it is a trick. I mean, there's a million ways I could have done that.
Right.
I would think that they're not actually linked. You know, maybe that's a small piece.
Right.
But if I pull these out, slowly you can see that they really are joined together. Now, it's the rule of a magician to never repeat a trick. But I'm going to show you the same trick again, but under test conditions in a far more amazing way. And it's a trick that actually fooled Houdini. I'm going to take the ropes, the white rope, and we're going to pass this through the cabinet. Now, we're going to come in as close as we can on the camera because I really want you to see this. We're going to lock it into place. And as I say, I'm going to show both of you this up close in a moment because I know the viewers at home, they trust you both.
Yeah,
and,
well,
they will take
one of us.
Good luck.
They will take your word for this. Robin, I think you're our nicest skeptic, but I want you to look at this yourself. I want you to see the arrangement and really make sure that those ropes are the same ropes that pass through. You can touch it. I want you to see that they don't link at any point in the middle.
Nope, they're all good. Mm.
They
okay.
really are separate.
Yeah.
You see, they really are separate, yeah?
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay, let's come in close here. For the camera, the ropes are separate. We're going to put a little bit of darkness inside of the cabinet. Now, Robin, I've got something a bit more modern here. It's a Sharpie. Can you
hold
on to it for me? And I'm going to take hold of the middles. I'm going to leave the ends outside, but could you take that pen for me, Robin, and pass it through the loops before I pull them anymore?
Okay.
Hurry up, Robin.
All the way through it so that it locks everything in place.
Yeah.
Houdini said the magic only happens when things pass through the cabinet. Could you hold on to the ends for me just
Love
here?
To.
Don't pull them just yet.
All right.
But if you could hold on to them, keep them tight, because I'm going to pull out the pen, and I'd like you to pull on those ropes.
All right.
It only happens when they pass through the cabinet, and keep them tight, because look.
Oh.
because those ropes truly are joined. If we pull the camera back, because I want you to let go with your hand, and if you could pull the ropes all the way through, Robin, you'll see those are the same ropes. They genuinely are joined together. They're the same ropes you checked at the start, and that was one of Houdini's favorite tricks.
Really?
Right.
I don't know how that happens.
Yeah, but it's fun.
Without clapping.
It's fun. You're a little evil. Just a little bit. No.